Good day, my name is Christelle from Frans de Klerk Independent Technical Analyst. Preston wanted us to look at Vukile, and the question was, can we see an inverted hammer? Now, I looked at the daily and the weekly graph, and the closest thing I could get to an inverted hammer, Preston, was maybe this candle there. Remember, an inverted hammer normally appears at the bottom of a sell-off with a long upper shadow and relatively small real body. It's the opposite of a shooting star. Remember, a shooting star appears at the top of a rally after a share has rallied, and the candle almost looks the same, a long upper shadow with a relatively small real body. But here a possible inverted hammer appeared at the bottom of a sell-off. But the confirmation of a possible turnaround lies within the next candle. And the next candle should be a bullish engulfing or a positive candle to imply a possible turnaround. At the moment, we didn't see that. The candle after this possible inverted hammer was clearly a bearish candle and therefore did not imply a possible turnaround. However, we can see that the share is making new lows in the last 3 weeks. But more importantly, the support of the week of the 11th of May, which is waiting at 4.64, is a critical level. The share needs to keep above that 4.64 level in order to support a possible turnaround. Yes, the share is oversold at the moment, but there's no divergence yet. In other words, the two lines within the stochastic is still pointing downwards, which implies that the momentum to the bottom is still in place. I do not have a turnaround candle. I don't have an indication on any of these candles that there might be some strength and that they might be protecting it. The first sign of strength on Vukile, and that is a possible entry level if for a buy, is only above 6 Rand. And then a stop loss that you can use is 4 Rand 64. First target is obviously that strong resistance at 7 Rand 59, 8 Rand 83, and 9.54. Also take note, Preston, there is a window here that is waiting between 11.50 and 11.40, a 10 cent window. And remember, the rules around windows are they always get closed. So that can act as a nice target for the share should the momentum turn around and we can see higher levels. Rue wanted us to look at City Lodge. We know there was a rights issue, but we can see that it's continuing to make new lows and that the momentum to the bottom is clearly in place. And if we maybe draw in a trend line here to identify the first sign of strength, we can see that that will only be visible when the share starts to consolidate here above 4.74. But at the moment, it's still too early to say that, Aru, because the momentum to the bottom is clearly in place. And if I draw a support line here at the previous bottom, we can see last week the share found strong support at 2.71, which is almost very close to that support on the 23rd of March at 2.73. So City Lodge is at the moment at a critical level. Will there be enough buyers to support this share in order to turn the share around? And the first sign of strength would obviously be above that 3.87 level, but that 4.47 level is a 4.74 level is a critical level that will imply a possible turnaround for the share should the buyers start to protect the share. And even if I move this a trend line higher, that is also the next strong resistance that needs to be overcome. And there's my three touching points, and that would be at 6.29. It's nicely oversold. We can see that on the stochastic. It is below a 20, but that stochastic needs to turn around. The two lines, especially my shorter K line, needs to break upwards through my orange line in order to confirm a divergence, in order to confirm a positive divergence for a possible turnaround on City Lodge. Brian wanted us to look at Ethereum, ETHUSD. And we can see at the moment, Brian, that, I mean, the instrument rallied massively. And now we're sitting here with a possible shooting star. Remember what I said, a shooting star appears at the top of a rally. It's got a long tail at the top, and it implies that the sellers are in control. It tells you that there were definitely traders who have taken profit. And the negativity or the pessimism or the possible turnaround of this instrument will only be confirmed if the next candle is a bearish or a belt, bearish belt outline, or a bearish engulfing, or even maybe a negative harami, something that implies or confirms the negativity that is implied in this candle this week. And remember, the candle is not finished yet, so this is a weekly graph. So in theory, you should wait for this candle to finish, and then in the next session, make your decision. So the first sign of weakness will be below $418.10. But confirmation of weakness will rather be below this line, because we can see that is a very, very strong support level. And that is waiting at $390.40. Below $390.40, the negativity would probably be confirmed for the second time on Ethereum. But above $489.70, and you can use that as a possible stop loss should you consider a short, above that level, we can assume then again that the momentum to the top can continue. First possible target would be $310.55, and that strong level at $237.35. Legend wanted us to look at the Consolidated Infrastructure Group. And Legend, one of the things that I always look for in a small stock, or especially a penny stock, or a share that has plummeted that much, is one, we need to see volume, and two, some indication of higher lows, whether it be on a line graph, which takes a little bit longer, or on a candle graph, either on the shadows or the real bodies. And at the moment, it's not visible on CIL yet. Yes, there is strong support and has been for the last couple of weeks at that level of around 14, 15 cents, and I'll give you that exactly, 15 cents. But now the big test is, can it change 28 cents into a support? That will be confirmation for me of a possible buying power and that the share might be on the turnaround. But if I look back at the history, there were times where the share maybe implied, hey, it is turning around, there is support, the buyers are coming in. But it seems time and time again that the sellers are just stronger and they take the share lower. So from a theoretical point of view, I would rather wait for higher lows. Wait for the share to bounce, pull back, and make sure that pullback is a little bit higher than the previous support. And then buy either on a confirmation of a turnaround or where that previous resistance was of about 61 cents. I mean, that is a lot of percentage away, but you also don't want to make sure you just get sucked in to get spit out. So that level of around 15 cents is this critical level that needs to remain a support, and then above 28 cents, first sign of strength, or if you want to wait for confirmation, higher lows. We can also see that there can be a possible Dara's model share. Why? It's been consolidating for almost 3 years already, just sideways, and now we need to wait for a jump in volume along with higher lows to confirm that this dancer will probably just rise to higher levels and do that perfect dance move to the top. Tracy wanted us to look at Famous Brands. We know the takeaways have been under pressure, that had an impact on different other food retailers as well. Recently RCL even mentioned that had an impact on their bottom line as well, because people didn't eat as many chicken takeaways like they did in the past. But Tracy, there is a cup and handle formation here, and I want to draw that for you with this beautiful cup, found resistance, and it might be working on a second handle here. Nobody knows how low it will go, but the rule will be that it needs to at least be higher than the support of the first handle. And even if it is a little bit, you know, like almost close to it, that's also fine. But nobody knows how many handles there is. But the strong support there around R34.70 needs to remain in place. The share is almost overbought. The stochastic is not in ideal territory to enter into a position. We prefer to enter it when it's oversold, but the graph looks strong. Now, the big test is that 40-week moving average, that red line. And take note, Tracy, how close that is waiting to that trend line. And that is at R50.66. R50.66 is a possible entry level if you want to chase the momentum, or if you want to buy on the idea of the cap and handle formation. And then stop loss you can use is this level there around 34.77. I can't see any windows at the moment on famous brands. That is a pity. But how can you establish a possible target for this cap and handle? You can either take the length of the first handle projected upwards, which means my famous brand share can go to 64.70, which is the conservative target. And if I take the full length of the cup, famous brands can possibly go back to 81 Rand 81 should the full formation play out.